So here with us we have state spokesperson Mr. Siraj Jafri of the MEP party. We have seen him talking on many other channels, so today we are privileged that he is with us today. So can you please tell us about MEP party, sir, today?
Yeah, see, MEP is not like any other political party. What they say in manifesto and adversely opposite they work into after coming into the power. But MEP party is a social working organization past 20 years, which has not been registered as MEP, but recently it has been registered as a political party throughout India. And now the elections are here in Karnataka Assembly. Hence, MEP has started, it's incepted in Karnataka for the Assembly elections 2018 Karnataka, and will be contesting in 224 seats. And the response from the public is immense. We are privileged, people are accepting, because past 70 years, people are fed up with the false promises and foul play with the political parties, which they are unable to fulfill. Right now, Mahila Empowerment Party is an alternative for the people who were looking out for the development in Karnataka. So we are hoping for the best in 2018 now.
One thing everyone wants to know, the face of the party is Dr. Nohira Sheikh, and she is not gonna take part in Karnataka election as if our information, what we have known till now. So how come the party will get through the success gate in this election?
See, that's a very good question actually. The party doesn't have any face of any of the political leader, because we are into a democratic country. Our party is public party, and it public is the face of this party. It has been incepted by the madam because of her visions, her aims, her distant vision and progressive thinking. She is taking a party ahead as an engine. But rest, the whole nation is a part of this party, whoever seeking a development without corruption.
As a new party, you must be targeting at least some of the constituencies. So I would like to ask you, which are the strongest areas like which you are predicting that you want to win this election?
See, in this case, entire India from Jammu and Kashmir to Kerala are the strongest areas wherein we are targeting. Why? Because every state, every district, every taluka has got its own problem. And the problem is not something which is very massive, and we have to have a lot of discussion and huge resources. These are the basic problems wherein people, what exactly people are looking out for in India. They are looking out for peace, they are looking out for purified drinking water, they are looking out for health system, proper healthcare system and proper education system. But unfortunately, past 70 years, these two nationalized parties, if I name them as Congress and BJP, they have looted this country. And at this point of time, you can see health system and education system has been commoditized, which is really shameful. As per our constitution, health and education are the basic rights, fundamental rights of this country. Whosoever needs, they should be availing those benefits in health and education. But unfortunately, how it has been commoditized, people who have money, they are accessible to the education and the health. People who don't have money, they are not accessible to the proper health and education system. That is the worst scenario of this country. Hence, we are targeting the whole nation. At this point of time, 2018, Karnataka Assembly election is the prime focus.
Whole of social media has been talking like this party has some special corner towards the BJP and that sort of things. Like, what is your opinion on this?
See, this is not any concrete thing to blame Mahila Empowerment Party. Yeah, this is a political gimmick played by the oppositions because they know now the failure of the system and the failure of the political hierarchy, they need someone to be blamed actually. So it is the fear of those political parties who are blaming us. In case if we were aligned with BJP, what they are saying, we would have not been contesting on 224 seats. We would have been targeting only those seats wherein BJP is trying to win, first thing. And secondly, they blame that we are aligned with that. I really don't understand when the serious issue of Muslim personal law, which was happening, and about the triple talaq issue, when the BJP was framing a criminal offense of 3 years penal for the men of Muslim community, that point of time, the same Congress who is opposing BJP now, they supported the bill in the parliament. And this is the hypocrisy of Congress, what they do. the Congress and the BJP are the two faces of a same coin. So I don't want to comment much on those people because their failures have the present situation of this country. People are facing that. So I need not have to comment anything on those people because they are already failed. People are giving proper answers to them wherever they are going in the constituencies. They are taking left and right of those people.
So in short, can you please explain what was the motto of today's press conference?
Today, Karnataka celebrity by name Jayalakshmi, she has joined hands with the Mahila Empowerment Party as an active member. So that is the reason Madam want to introduce her to the public as a public figure, as a celebrity. She has joined our party looking at the mottos and the aims, vision, distant vision and the social work of this organization. She is willfully joined our party and she may be contesting in upcoming elections as well. That is the reason we have called a press conference today.
Thank you, sir. We really feel privileged to have you here. Thank you for talking to us.
That was wonderful talking to you as well.
We hope you do wonders to India and Karnataka. Thank you.